Now we are doing a problem to find the lower and upper sums to find the area under the graph f of x is equal to 2x on closed interval 0, 1. How will you find the solution? Let us divide the given interval 0, 1 into n equal subintervals with the partitions of the given form 0, 1 by n, 2 by n, etc., etc., n minus 1 by n, 1. What you are doing is to divide 0, 1 into n equal parts, you are using the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., up to n, and you are dividing by small n, that is 0 by n will become 0, 1 divided by n will become 1 by n, 2 divided by n becomes 2 by n, then the last but 1, n minus 1 by n, then final n by n, it will become 1. Then you are going to define g and h as follows, that is the step function g of x, it is equal to 2 into I minus 1 by n for I minus 1 by n less than or equal to x less than I by n, where I values from 1 to n. The given function is 2x. So here, in order to define g of x, which is smaller than the given function f of x, you are taking the lower limit of the interval I minus 1 by n less than or equal to x less than I n, the lower limit is I minus 1 by n. So instead of x, you are writing 2x means 2i minus 1 by n. Then for the fixed value x equal to 1, you are giving the value for g of x is equal to 2. For finding h of x, which is greater than f of x, the same subinterval I minus 1 by n less than x less than I by n, you are taking the upper limit, that is I by n. So 2x will become h of x is equal to 2i by n for I minus 1 by n less than or equal to x less than I by n. Again the fixed value 2x, that is x equals 1, will become the value 2. So f of x is equal to 2x for every x belongs to 0, 1, you are defining g of x and the h of x as like this. So for all x belonging to 0, 1, it is possible to find I is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n, and you can carry on. In the next slide, we are going to see how we are calculating those values, that is for I minus 1 by n less than x less than I by n, the given interval you are multiplying throughout by 2. You will get 2 into I minus 1 by n less than or equal to 2x less than 2i by n. Then you can say the first one is g of x, it will implies g of x less than or equal to f of x, which is 2x, and it is less than hx, which is 2 into I by n. So g of 1 equals h of 1 equals 2, which is equal to f of 1. So you can say that g of x is less than or equal to f of x less than or equal to h of x for every x which is belonging to 0, 1. The step function g of x lies below f of x, and the step function h of x lies above f of x. So they're using the lower sum capital L for small f. In the given interval 0, 1, you will find the area of the given step function. It is given by capital L is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 to n k I delta x I. It is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 to n 2 into I minus 1 by n into I by n minus I minus 1 by n. It is equal to sigma I equals 1 to n 2 I minus 1 by n into 1 by n. So you can take that 2 outside, 1 by n into 1 by n outside, 2 by n square, sigma I is equal to 1 to n into I minus 1. So 2 by n square into, you are expanding that sigma I equals 1 to n minus sigma I equals 1 to n 1 becomes 2 by n square, then you are getting here the values to be equal to sigma I equals 1 to n will become n into n plus 1 by 2, the sum of terms minus n. So you will get n plus 1 by n, you can cancel the values, n square you will get minus 2 by n, it is equal to, you will get it as 2 by n final answer you will get it as 1 minus 1 by n. And in the next slide, you can see how you will find the upper sum, capital M for upper sum 0, 1. The area under the graph of the step function is given by the formula sigma I equals 1 to n capital M I into delta X I. Now, taking the values approximately, you will get sigma I equals 1 to n to I by n into I by n minus of I minus 1 by n. So, 2 I by n into again 1 by n, 2 by n square, take outside sigma I equals 1 to n 1, that is n into n plus 1 by 2. You will get the final answers to be 2 by n square into n plus 1 by 2. And then the final answer you will getting it as into n plus 1 by n. So, the final answer you will get it as 1 plus 1 by n. So, one lower area is 1 minus 1 by n, the lower sum upper area is 1 plus 1 by n. So, you can write the inequality as capital A is denoted by the area of the graph. In between this lower sum and upper sum lies the actual area. So, 1 minus 1 by n is equal to capital L, which is less than or equal to capital A, less than or equal to capital M, which is upper sum 1 plus 1 by n for all n. So, when you can see that the inequality when n tends to infinity, the value of n becomes very, very, very large, 1 by n will tend to 0. So, you get the final area 1 plus 1 by n will become 0, 1 minus 1 by n will become 0. So, final area capital A is equal to 1. So, in this method, we can find the area of the given problem by making use of the unit function, step functions which are given. Thank you, friends.